I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
People of the minutes.
Second.
The motion in the second. All in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Aye. All opposed, same sign. Unanimous motion approved. Approve the agenda.
I'd like to make a motion to amend the agenda to very quickly talk about bond debt.
I don't know what.
Ramsey County's bond debt.
Why would you put that large of a state pen on the agenda? And we don't have that on there.
That email that Carrie sent.
I amend my motion to include that.
Oh, yeah, with the whole system. Yeah, I think we should just look at it.
Okay, then I'll amend my motion to include discussion on that.
There's a motion, is there a second?
Second.
All in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Aye. Opposed, same sign. Unanimous motion carried. Roger.
Whether or not all of you are aware, a week ago Sunday during Open Gym that the park board sponsors, they tore about 6 inches off the base of one of the curtains on the back of the gym and ripped about seven feet tall. Jeff was possibly the only one that had seen it. And I guess number one is determine who exactly should be liable for those damages. Now, the county has a lease agreement with the park board, and I think most of you have that agreement. You know, the right at the top, whereas the leasee requests the use of the Memorial Building Gymnasium, volleyball, league games, and it does not specifically say Open Gym. However, it does, as it goes on, youth volleyball practices and after school activities, etc. Well, to me, the etc. would be the Open Gym. And if you go down to line 8, any damage to the memorial building that occurs while being used will be paid for by the lessee, who's the park board. Okay? Now, Terry Wallace has a separate agreement, or the park board has a separate agreement with this Brandon Henderson, where Brandon is supposed to be liable for any damages. But I would say that's between the park board and Brandon. The one between the county and the park board is the one we ought to go with.
Yep.
That's because correct. That's just like a subcontractor.
Yep. Right.
So. I guess that was the number one thing I wanted tonight, just to establish that.
She had her dates turned up at this.
She did.
Determination.
Yes. I thought she was going to have a her determination here tonight.
She didn't get time to, but she said that it would stand to go with the lease with the park board.
Yeah.
Well, because that's what we're a signer on, right? I mean,
yep.
So that's correct. And then I think that if the park board does or does not get reimbursed by whomever they have a subcontract with, it doesn't matter to us.
Yeah, exactly. That's
yeah. And that's pretty much her wording.
Yeah.
Have you talked to Terry on it? Or
have talked to who?
With Terry.
I have not, but I want to talk to you guys first.
Make sure we were behind you.
Well, I saw no reason why this agreement between the park board and some individual had anything to do with us.
No.
So anyway, I am in the process of trying to get estimates to replace that section of curtain. I talked to Doug Darling from the college. He was going to try and get me information. I talked to him this weekend and couldn't get a hold of him today. And the people we get our flags with, I've talked to them and they're not positive whether or not. So as soon as I get estimates on this, I will bring them back to the board. So to replace that section of curtain. I don't think sewing it up again would be an absolute last resort. I do have the piece that was torn off the bottom, but I would certainly rather replace it, if at all possible.
You mean it was sewn up once, Roger?
No, it's never been sewn up again. I did hear Terry Wall said we can just sew it up again, and no, that's not a good idea. I mean, it wouldn't look, I don't think, good at all. But like I said, if we absolutely can't find anything, I got the pieces, then that might be our only option. So.
I need to give the commissioners kind of a perspective of where it is, and it's the back curtain that kind of closes off the back of the stage to the audience. It's that black curtain, it's got black sides, and it's a black back, and it's one of the side ones that was was ripped on the bottom and up the side. And I don't know if it would be necessarily really highly visible if we had a, depending on the seamstress that was, that did it, but like Roger said, I think that would be kind of the last resort kind of thing, you know, if we can't find matching curtains to you know, instead of having to replace all three sections, there'd be four sections, because the back is two sections and then the two sides, you know. So.
Well, I think regardless of whether we repair it or replace it, it's still on the park board.
Right.
To reimburse us for whatever those costs are.
Yeah, I agree.
And so I think, you know, we need a motion to have Roger get estimates to have that done and report back at our next meeting.
Or as soon as I get estimates.
Or as soon as you get estimates.
Do you want to get the estimates and then talk with the park board first to see if they're okay with that? Or do you want to bring them to us first and then
I'll bring them to you.
I think Carrie did say that if we needed a letter, you know, written to the park board on behalf of the county commissioners, that she would do a job something.
A lot on your estimate.
Yeah.
Right. Okay.
Then kind of, I've had some discussion. This open gym thing, there's been some issues there also, people being in there at really odd times. I've switched people out of there at really odd times. I just wonder, you know, and what gives the park board the right to sublease it to somebody else without our approval? I just think there's too many people in there at strange times, and you know, I've talked to Roger, I've talked to Candy about it. I think maybe we need to address this whole open gym thing. There's two separate items. One's an open gym and the other one's the contract with the park board. So I've been in here at, you know, after an event's been here at 7, 8 o'clock, and there's three guys standing here. And it's like, what are you doing here? Oh, we're going to shoot basketballs. There's nobody holding basketballs. There's just three guys standing in our building. And it's like, what are you doing in here? So, and that's happened several times now. And I think Roger's probably swished some people out at odd times.
Just this weekend, they were told this Henderson was with Terry Wallace when we were looking at the curtains last week, and we told him that there would be no open gym this past weekend because of the gun show. And I came by after we all left the building, and I came by about an hour later, and I had my pickup parked back here, and I said, well, I heard a basket, you know, you can hear the basketballs if you walk by the gym. I walked in there and here they are playing basketball. I said, I know you were told there was no open gym this weekend. And he said, well, yeah, but there's nobody in here. I said, that's true, but the point is you were told there was no open gym this weekend. So that means there's no open gym, whether you got a key or not.
And then so, I kind of question how many keys are out there.
Candy and I have had many discussions over the years of how many keys are out there. And I talked to Lakeside Lock and Key this afternoon about possibly getting new keys made for the memorial building. And he said he was guessing somewhere between $250 and $300 to get all. To get the locks changed and we get new keys for it. And I don't think that's a bad idea at all.
I agree.
Yeah. You think that's gonna stop it?
Well, for a little while, until.
A month?
Well, I don't know.
No, but I made the suggestion of having like a key checkout or a key sign sheet here.
You know, we can always.
So that we can keep track of.
Who's in there?
Who has keys?
Yeah.
You know, what it's for.
Chris Henderson is the park board responsible, right?
Yes.
We have a lease with that.
Yeah.
But there is always a possibility of saying no more open gym.
Well, then probably have to specify that.
Let's put the brakes on here a little bit. We can keep some kids off the street, keep their nose clean, goddamn it.
Okay.
Keeping that building open for that is well worth it, we can keep it under control.
Wow.
I think that's the biggest thing.
But I don't think it's kids that are the issue.
Pardon?
The ones that I throw out are not kids.
Well, they're 20-something year olds, yes.
Do they have to report the schedule to you so we know when things are going on?
They're supposed to, but they never do.
They get a schedule from us when they come and say that they're going to start, and they get it from the month they begin to all the way to the month that's end. And we go through the whole calendar, and we tell them when it's available and when it's not.
But then they give us nothing back saying when they're going to be doing things?
No.
Well, I think
you know. Well, I mean, it's usually Saturdays and Sundays.
Yeah. And that's the only
is the designated time.
Yeah.
But you know, they've been in there before the time that they're supposed to start. They've been in there after the time that they're supposed to be.
Well,
you know,
that's kids.
Well,
you're
but
kids.
It's no, it's
but,
not.
But Ed, it's not kids. These are
it's adults.
20 to 30 year olds and. I know for a fact that there was beer, you know, left from Shane's there, and you've got all these people running in and out, and it's just, to me, there's going to be a huge liability one day.
Beer from the?
From the
fishing tournament. And they were not supposed to be in there that weekend, and they knew it.
And they were in there. I mean, they've been told and told and told, and I've rented this building and been in there at night and had them come in and say, well, we're going to play basketball, and I've said, no, you're not. Well, I said, I don't care who you are. You know, the building's rented. Well, we'll just play over here because you're over there. Well, no, that's not how it works. They don't seem to have any respect for the rules. I wouldn't have an issue if they had respect for the rules. And if it was kids, it'd be a whole different deal. But these are young adults. These are not connected with the Devil's Lake Park Board per se. So that's where my big issue is. And
are we sure they're not connected to the Double A Park Board?
Yeah.
Well, only connection would be as a park board. Supposedly, if they would be injured, the park board insures them.
Yes.
That's their only connection to the park board.
That's the only way that they can use the facility.
Yeah, that's the only way they can use it.
Now let me ask you another question. If open gym is this time and they come in and injure themselves in a time that's not open gym hours.
Yeah, and that's why I'm saying.
But we have no published open gym.
No.
You know, so I mean it's
I mean
a free for all.
He definitely has something
here.
You know, he has something going because in watching the video, I mean, there were 30 plus people there.
To me it sounds like a communication issue.
Yeah.
You were there.
We're telling
no, Candy? when we watched the video when all the stuff went on, you know, there were 30 plus. And it wasn't like kids my age, you know, grade school.
You're
like
a kid.
It was,
yeah.
my kids' age.
But there was some supervision there.
Well,
you
the one
see
that's,
anybody that was supervising?
No, he was playing. The kid that is in charge that has the key
is playing basketball with the rest of them.
Oh, that's all right.
And then everybody was, you know.
No.
I just think
what's he 20, 25
bad.
Years old? You said.
How
old
is he? I don't
know. He's
20?
Gonna be in his
30s. Oh, 30.
Oh.
Jeez, that should be responsible,
well,
right?
I was just
going
to say that doesn't make him responsible. I just
but he's
30.
Not.
Oh
my gosh.
I mean,
no.
he signed the contract with the park board. He does the rules and regulations. I mean,
but he's not
like
listening
I said,
to any of them.
Like I said, to me it's a communication issue. We need the park board. We'll give I think what we should do is we should give them a schedule of when the times are open. Then they should have to give us a schedule back saying when they're going to be in there using it so we know. And then at that point, they know what the rules are. They sublet it to somebody for open basketball, and if we have a problem or see a problem, we talk to the park board. They enforce it on the person they've got a subcontract with. And if it's not enforced, then we have to come to court at some point.
Maybe we should just have.
But we have to give them a chance, I think, still.
Have them come in and.
I agree.
We should have a chance to sit down with Terry Wallace.
Yeah.
No, I agree.
I think that's reasonable.
We try to do that. I mean, that's.
Let's try to be reasonable, because we have a nice big gym. We might as well try to let people play basketball.
Yeah, that's crazy.
If people are breaking things or ruining things or doing stuff they're not supposed to, that's the main point, I agree.
I think if it was run differently, you know, that it would be beneficial to a lot more people.
Well, and maybe that's the discussion that needs to be had with the park board. They need to realize, you know, if you're gonna have an open gym, that's fine, but we need somebody that's gonna really keep track of it and make sure things are running well, and, you know.
Well, and is one person, just one person have a key for open gym, or is it several, or is it?
That who has keys.
You know,
maybe the park board should tell us who has keys too, so
you know. Because is this one person monopolizing the open gym time? You know, or is it available for others? You know, because open gym is really a difficult scenario here in town, because our school gyms are jam-packed with activities every night till, you know, people go to bed. You know, we have...
But are they school activities or just...
Well, some of them are. Some of them are most of them are parents that have younger kids that are in a traveling basketball team or a volleyball or just want some indoor recreation in the wintertime. But there's something going on in the gyms every hour, every night, every weekend, you know, and but it becomes a scheduling nightmare. I think we have a staff person at the school that's kind of dedicated for that, and it drives Danny a little bit nuts sometimes. I mean, Ed, you know how that scenario all worked out, but we need to, I think it's a good service to provide, you know, to have that open gym availability, but I don't like to see some one person have monopoly on it either.
Well, and I think that sort of strikes to the core of the problem is that it's great that things are going on there, right? But if we don't know what's going on there, right?
Yeah.
I hate to say it, but that's the closest thing Hill's Lake has to a wellness center.
Right.
Right there.
Yep.
I mean, it's...
Yeah. I use it all the time, right?
You've got to go to the only place you can get into a gym.
Well, just make sure that it's utilized properly and with some respect to the facility itself.
Maybe he needs either more or different people in charge.
Yeah.
Could be that.
Yeah.
Something we could talk, you know you're in charge of it, and you know, you're going to be visiting with Terry about it, bring it up and visit with him about it when we're talking about the curtain.
Do you want Terry to come in to the next meeting?
I think that would be good.
Yeah.
Oh, whatever.
That would be a good idea.
Let's see what we can come up with.
Yeah, I mean, because we want to use it if we can.
Yeah.
It's just a matter of making sure that we're doing it right.
Right.
Yeah, I used to go up to the Curry Gym all the time. Started in Brother 5th, 6th grade.
I did too. It's a good old
thing. You always tell you, don't break anything up for you.
Yeah, you ain't coming in again.
Privilege you go away.
That's right. We do that.
And there's no doubt that.
So,
basketball players out there.
Roger, what do you need from us?
Well, we're good right now. I guess, like I said, we've pretty well established that the park board is going to be responsible for the payment of the curtain, however that pans out. And yes, I'll talk to Terry Wallace and have him come in the next meeting and try and get something a little better squared away than what exists now. Mark, regarding that other person you were asking about shooting baskets.
Yep.
Okay, now, go ahead.
Oh no, I'll let you go ahead. That's what I was just going to say.
Mark asked me about some individual who was doing some sort of physical therapy or something.
Yep.
Okay,
yep.
He wants to, when he's walking in a gym, he wants to stop and shoot baskets. Okay, that's fine. However, I chased a kid out in the middle of the afternoon, kid meaning 25, 30 years old, for shooting baskets. Because in the past, for many years past, it was always, we didn't have people shooting baskets simply because you probably get two and sooner or later you got a game going. And just because of liability issues, we've always said, sorry, no basketball, just, you know, go to open gym. If if you want to play basketball. So I'm just thinking in my mind of, you got one guy in there shooting baskets, and you get some other, even a teenage kid come in and say, well, how can he do it and I can't? I guess that's my point I'm trying to make.
And this individual that we're talking about approached me last week. He's 60 years old. He said the minute anybody else showed up, he said he would quit. And I just said, you know what, just go ahead, we'll bring it up at our next meeting and see what, you know, the commissioners think at that time. So that's why.
Yeah, that's the only thing, you know.
Yeah, I understand that, you know, we don't want all of a sudden a basketball game going on at 2 in the afternoon in the gym.
Guess that was it, you know, the easiest thing way back 20 years ago, just say no to everyone, that way there's never an issue of a clash of somebody, yes, you got permission, and this one you say no. So I don't know.
This is during work day?
No. Yes. Yeah.
Because they walk in there.
Yes.
During the
day. Yeah, you get people in there just walking during the day. It's, you know, a lot of them, it's a kind of a big social thing for several retired people in the morning. You know, they come in and walk, and so, and yeah, I realize that this person probably isn't going to be starting a game, but still, again, you might run into issues with, like I said, somebody else coming in and saying, well, if he can shoot baskets, why can't I?
Like so, I said earlier, this is the closest thing we have to a wellness center.
True. Or do we want to let everyone shoot baskets?
Well, there's too many offices around the outside the gym that are getting used. None.
Yeah, next closest thing would be for essential planning or during the day if people were using the meeting room, I suppose.
You know, but I think the time frame that, you know, he's talking about, when he's here, you know, kids are in school. I mean, he'll probably be here as soon as the building opens.
The kids are usually up here at what, 4:30?
After school.
Yeah.
You know.
But the one that I got out of here, I would say he was college age or a little older even. That was 2:00 in the afternoon. And I just happened to be coming up there and I heard the basketball in the gym. And I just tell them the same thing I've told everyone, and there's never been an issue. Just say, I'm sorry, but due to insurance reasons, we can't have you playing basketball in case you're injured. And nobody's ever given me any grief, and they've just left. So, I guess my question is, what do you want to do?
But we have people in here walking.
Yes.
That's been going on for quite a while.
As long as I've been here. That isn't all day long either, but yeah, right away in the morning, you'll get several that come in, they have for many years, and then it's quiet for a while, and then you'll get your straggler here and there, and so.
Usually there's someone here at 7:30 waiting for Roger to open up.
Yeah, they mail.
Yeah.
Good for them.
Yeah.
Well, we don't sure you want to shut that down.
No.
Or can we try to run it by case by case? Oh, I know there's a big open hole there. I understand that completely.
I don't know. Good question. What a wellness center would do, huh?
Yeah. And if you just want to let whoever shoot baskets, yeah, that's fine with me, just as long as you guys approve it.
That wouldn't create too much noise during the day?
All depends upon, you know, once word got out, it might be...
Well, crazy.
That's what I'm worried about. Are we going to have everybody playing basketball while the elderly are trying to walk?
Right, and that's another issue, yes.
You know, but with his purpose, I mean, it's...
Yeah, his purpose was to
therapy.
To do his arm and you know, that's why I was just wondering if somebody approached Candy or Roger and said, hey, I have a doctor's deal, I'm supposed to do this, and there's a big difference. I understand, but there's a huge difference between a 60-year-old guy doing this and then somebody from the college coming out here playing basketball. There's a big difference.
Yes, there is a big difference. But
well, then why don't we just say this? Nobody's allowed to play basketball or like shoot hoops, whatever it may be, unless they have the express written permission of either Candy or Roger. And in that case.
Put it all on me.
Roger doesn't want that.
I'll put it all on me.
I mean, because presumably you're not going to have very many people who come in for purposes other than playing basketball. And if a bunch of kids come in and say, well, you know, I mean, you'll know then, right? Mm-hmm. And it seems fairly easy.
And you could run into the problem, you know, kids or whomever saying, well, you're playing favorites, or, you know, you make a decision off of, you know, whatever you know type of thing.
The park board has nothing to do with the walking?
No.
Maybe we need to ask him for a doctor's note.
I'm sure he's worried about the walking, but
I don't know.
Answer on shooting baskets.
Yeah, I don't know.
I think years ago when it was brought up, I think it was a risk of injury on an errant rebound or something like that.
Yeah, and that'd be the same thing now, of course.
For an elderly person walking.
Yes.
You know, they're busy walking and visiting, and all of a sudden a ball comes and hits them in the noggin.
Yeah.
Could have a bigger issue than.
Yeah.
I think that's why it was kind of eliminated during the day.
I think you probably better leave that alone.
Man, probably have to tell them. That's no good.
Yeah.
Not much of a choice to tell.
Okay.
I just wanted to get it out in the open here.
That's a good discussion.
Has he been in here, do you know?
No, I thought more. Okay.
The guy just walks and shoots baskets?
Yeah, I don't think he's been here, not that I'm aware of. I haven't seen him.
But he's been here.
I don't know. He just came and asked me permission one day.
He probably wasn't going to until you got back.
No, I told him just to go ahead.
Well, I haven't heard it, so. And usually, even way down here, you can hear a basketball. Okay. It's amazing how that kick sound carries. So.
Well, we can ponder it too. See if anybody comes up with any other ideas. We'll go with what is the rule today then.
With that, no, think about it.
Okay. All right, that's all I've got. So, like I said, next meeting I'll have Terry Walls come in, and hopefully by then I'll have some estimates for Curtis.
Okay. Thank you, Roger.
Thanks.
Kevin's up.
All right. Kevin Wolfer has got a 2-minute announcement. Want to do it now or wait till after the visitors?
We should just do it now. Who wants to get home and have supper?
Yeah.
I just want to make sure the customer, the commissioners know about our customer appreciation breakfast that's coming this Saturday. Just hoping you guys got them in the mail.
Thank you.
Yeah, I got them. Thank you. We start cooking at 7 a.m. and
thank you.
We clean our shop out. We have everybody in the store involved in it, and it's just a way of showing our appreciation for business in the life region area, and just wanted to let you guys know about that. If you get in the mail, we got all the lists updated, so we got a bouncy house for the kids, so it's usually a big hit, and a lot of pancakes and sausage and eggs.
Great.
You guys are all more than welcome to come out and enjoy the morning with us. And that's pretty much all I had. And
okay.
Say thank you.
Thank you.
Okay, my first item, the house is gone now. The whole ground is still there. We put the orange fence around it, but so that is gone. All we have left now is to fill a hole this spring, this summer.
So Kevin, did we coordinated all that with district health before we did that?
Yep.
Yeah.
Yep, we had to get that permit to. And the whole part of the permit, you have to prove who did the asbestos inspection, and you have to prove who did the cleanup. So that was all on the application. Any other questions on the house? I haven't seen a bill for the asbestos cleanup or the demolition yet, so hopefully we'll have them for next meeting.
They did a good job. It's clean over there. I mean,
it is clean.
It's really clean. I was like shocked when I drove by.
And we know what the bill is on the demo, because we had the, but we just aren't quite sure what the asbestos is gonna be.
Right. Okay, and then I also sent everyone a map of all the railroad crossings that don't have lights or gates. There's quite a few, a lot more than you would think. And I think the reason for this, we were talking about getting some of them blinky lights or whatever. And not sure where we put them or anything, but solar powered ones.
Probably put some collars up, huh?
Yeah, we wouldn't be able to do collars till spring, the snow plows would destroy them, but that's an idea. Ramsey 4 over by Southland doesn't have any, but that's the NP line, so it's not the high traffic line.
Right, yeah. I don't think we need to really look at that.
I think that train doesn't go
25-30.
Yeah, it don't go very fast.
Yeah, it goes pretty slowly there.
Yeah.
And there's a really good sight distance there too, unless
right.
Better than most.
Yeah, it's not like at Roarville where we had to have March and so right. You can see a thing coming.
I'd almost think with that fishing pier that road there has probably as much as all these combined in a day. That fishing pier creates a lot of traffic.
Which one?
That fishing pier out there.
The Channel 8 one?
Channel 8.
Certainly will with the little
way bass.
Exactly where it is.
The little way bass.
The one next.
Got the question mark on? That's the one.
Next one over.
Next one over.
The check marks at Grand Harbor.
To the west.
To the west. Question mark was underwater.
Oh, it's the one to the left, to the west of the question mark.
Yeah.
That's the one we've been talking about, right?
Yes,
right.
It is.
I'll leave the mirrors back in here.
So it looks like we got what, I can't count those X's, they're kind of small, but I think there's like 23 or something like that.
Pretty cool.
I would think the one north of the rest area would be, all year round too, would be a good candidate. Quite a bit of traffic would love that road. County Line Road over there. I'm sure you're going to get Nelson to go along with some of that from the cattle.
Yeah, I would think so. Sure wouldn't hurt to ask.
That'd be the two east of town that I would be familiar with. They have a lot of traffic.
Also, the one on the truck route, that's kind of ends when it crosses the road there. It's just a dead end, so it's not like there's a lot of traffic there either. And that's the NP line.
Yeah, because BNSF has a crossing arms on that one.
Yes, on the first one.
On the truck route?
Yeah. And just a little ways north of there, there's another double.
The NP one does not have anything.
Right.
Penn has arms, right?
No, arms.
Penn?
Penn has arms, yes.
Penn has arms.
In town?
Yep.
The one that raised in town.
Right.
Okay. I'm not familiar with the mother crossing, I guess. I'll take some questions or answers from the township supervisor. I want to see what they think.
The next one west is the one that goes to Danny Webster's farm storage site. I don't know if you're familiar with that road. So there's two residents, and then Danny's storage, and that's it. It dead ends into the lake after that.
One west of Penn?
Yes. The one that goes two crossings east of Penn, that's goes to Shimonex and serves all those people that live up there. There's probably 1, 2, 3, 4, I would guess 6 or 7 homes up there.
When they redid that road, there was quite a bit of an elevation difference. Did they?
Not at this crossing.
Not at the crossing, there wasn't?
That's the question.
Yeah.
No, it didn't change the crossing.
Okay.
It was already high. And
yeah.
You think that'd be a good candidate for lights?
That'd be a good one to put a counter on this spring or this summer. It's school bus goes, there's a family with two children up there, so the school bus goes up there.
I think it'd be a good thing to, you know, we're kind of discussing it now, but just try to figure out where the first places we should put counters are and then try to get data on all the locations, and then we can kind of make a determination from there, you know, at least where we're shooting at here. I mean,
well, certainly that 75th that we've been looking at would be the first one I'd like to see a counter on, you know, especially after spring thaw and the fishermen, especially the shore fishermen, start getting up there.
Mm-hmm.
You know, they'll probably be up there before the boat launches.
Open up.
But, you know.
You haven't heard nothing more from the state on that one.
Oh, no.
Alarms that they're talking about.
Still catch was scheduled for 2017, but no estimates or anything like that. Yeah.
That's what I'm assuming is that that one will go in. You know?
Yeah. That was what the email said, is that one will get it up in 2017, but no costs or no dates yet.
Okay.
So we'll just keep that on the back burner for now.
Do we put those counters out when the snow is gone?
Yep. Then that'll be after the snow's gone, so we don't wipe them out with our clothes.
That'd be good.
All right. Next is the, we actually did get the contract for the replacement of the crossing on, I guess I skipped number three, but the crossing on Royalville Road. And so they want us to sign that contract. We're responsible for the 10% share. And it's scheduled for that full concrete pound crossing. And so I guess we'd need a motion to sign that contract.
So moved.
Second.
Okay. Can I just want to ask one question? Yeah. So is that for sure they know the price? Have they already put it out on bids? Or?
That's what the contract will say, but no, it could go up or down or,
okay,
you know, depending on...
This is essentially the engineer's estimate.
Yep, exactly.
And we're just saying we'll at least commit to...
We're saying we're going to commit to 10%. No matter.
Yeah, whatever it is.
Yeah.
But it should be in that ballpark, hopefully, since people are looking for work. Hopefully.
The contract says that we're responsible for 10%, and we're assuming this is about what it's going to be.
Okay.
So they're not...
Estimated project.
Okay, yeah, I figured it was just an engineer's estimate because they haven't let any bids out yet.
Okay, there's a motion and a second. All in favor, signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Aye. Opposed, same sign. Being the motion carried. Okay.
Going back to three, I'd make that motion to put the load restrictions on at the same time the State Highway Department puts theirs on.
There's a motion. Is there a second?
Second.
There's a motion and a second to put load restrictions on the same time the state highway. All in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Aye. Opposed, same sign. Being none, motion carried.
And just a little bit further, and I did talk to them about that today, and they aren't even talking about it out west yet. And generally it starts out west and moves this way, but they're not even talking about it out there yet. It's just
probably won't move on until they get their project from Martin County cleaned up, huh?
Yeah.
Possibly.
Okay, number five is we need to set the valves on the engines on our cat motor graders. They got 2,000 hours on them. That's part of maintenance on all those diesel engines.
Move to approve.
Okay. There's a motion and a second. All in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Aye. All opposed, same sign. And that motion carried.
And along with that, we need to change, with the 2,000 hour service, we need to change all the oils, except for the transmission, and then filters, and that's going to cost $4,500. So I like motion for that.
So, motion, is there a second?
Second.
Why do we need to approve all this stuff for Kevin? I can't, it seems to me that it's micromanaging to the finest. You know, it's something that's regular maintenance on his equipment. And it's something that he budgets for. I mean, we approved the budgets. I mean, you come back in November, October, November, December with overspending your budget, well, you know, slap your hand on it. But and to me, this is just really unnecessary
How long has it been that way, Kevin?
Oh gosh, I've been here 20 years.
I was going to say.
Way to hell before my
boy.
Forever.
I can remember getting reprimanded for not doing it too, so, but that's a different commission too, so
well,
I understand.
It just seems to me that, you know, it ties your hands, you know, you're doing regular maintenance on your equipment. Changing tires, I think we approved last meeting,
yeah,
on your skid steer.
Yeah.
You know, now it's a change in oil.
Yeah.
What would you do if we said no?
I don't know. Good question.
That's a good question.
Hope the warranty's good.
Yeah.
I like these easy decisions.
Well, you know, it's a very easy decision, but it's
no, I'm not.
It's really unnecessary.
I know what you're saying, Jeff. I've kind of shook my head too, but I've never made an issue.
But well, I don't want to make an issue, but it just seems
good to know it's getting done though.
Yeah. Well, you know. Coming and letting us know that you've done it is great, but having to go through and approving the expenditures to go ahead and do it seems a little. But with that, let's go ahead and.
We'd have to draw a line here.
Well,
or you just
know,
right, change your.
The dollar figures are drawn online, but I always assume Kevin just brought it to us because he wanted us to know what was going on.
Yeah.
I always looked at
it. Well, you know, it's good information.
Yeah.
But,
I mean, one time you had all the farmers sitting there.
Yeah, and they wanted to know. That's why.
Well, I think you're exactly right.
Where are you getting that oil from?
Yeah, or who you buy it
from.
Yeah.
I'd like to know what the Caterpillar's charging all the time.
Yeah.
Do we get a deal today?
You get breakfast.
We get that breakfast, aren't we?
Okay, we have a motion and a second. Let's have a roll call on this one.
You don't want to
address
them.
We already did, one subject each dollar.
We probably should enroll call the one that was like $129,000 versus the other two.
Okay.
Oh, we didn't spend the money yet.
Spent it.
We just approved a bit.
Right.
We're not paying
when
for
we get, when we get the bill, then we'll
present
that.
Yeah.
We're
no,
not
that
sure
is,
what
that
it's
is
going
our,
to
be. That is our 10%, isn't it?
Yeah.
No, our 10% is 10% of that. Okay.
Right.
We're down to that 13,000
range. Yeah.
Yeah.
But we won't have to roll call it until we actually get the bill.
Okay. Gotcha. Hold the total cost. Okay. So you still want to roll call this one?
Sure. Why not?
Okay. Google Brown.
Aye.
Fred.
Aye.
Lighton.
Aye.
Wakefield.
Aye.
Olson.
Aye.
Motion carried. And the last thing I have is set the blading rates for 2017. Our cost didn't change a whole lot from last year, so I have them listed there. I guess my recommendation would be to leave the same this year.
Move to approve.
Second. There's a motion and a second. All in favor, signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Aye. Opposed, same sign. Being none, motion carried. That's all I have. Thank you, Kevin.
Thank you.
And the unfinished business board appointments.
We got to use one, yeah.
I gave it until the next.
Oh.
Until the next.
Oh, so we should have some at the first meeting of March.
I'll move to
hopefully.
Table this then.
Second.
I hope so.
Well, what are the boards again? Maybe Chuck would do
the library board.
Sure, we look it up for you real quick.
We need a library board representative and a
special assessment commission, I believe, and then two for Forward Devil's Lake.
Okay. I'm not allowed to do any of that.
No, just include that in your story if you want.
Sure.
I know that we need people that would be interested in serving on those boards.
Yes, you did.
Great.
Thank you.
I'll email you the details of it.
That sounds good.
Thanks, Chuck.
Sure. Thank you. Approved raffle permit.
Move to approve.
Second.
Motion and seconds. All in favor?
We never voted on tabling the last one.
Oh.
Oh, yeah.
You did not.
I got it. Sorry
about
that.
Thank you. Motion and a second to table the board appointments.
You made the motion to table, I made the second.
Motion and a second. All in favor, signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Aye. Opposed, same sign. Being none, motion carried. Approve the raffle permits. And Ed made a motion to approve.
think Adam seconded that, or?
Oh, no.
No, I did.
Lucas did.
Lucas did, okay.
There's a motion and a second.
I like Apple's motion.
All in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Aye. Hold the same sign, being none, motion carried. Approve homestead credits. Motion, is there a second?
Second.
Motion and a second, all in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Aye. Hold the same sign, being none, motion carried.
And that's for both of them?
Yeah.
Approve there.
Yeah, 15 and 16.
One was for 2015, and one was for 2016.
Approve senior citizens funds.
So what are we approving here?
We got payout from the state, we get levy money, we got 44,000 something, and then we have 50,246 in that fund, so we'll just, when we get money, that state levy money from, you know, the state, then we pay out what those senior citizen boards have requested for the year, so that they can operate.
So we have the 44 plus the 50 makes 94.
Yep. So we have like 94.
We're approving paying out the 77,000.
Yep.
Motion approved.
There's a motion, is there a second?
Second.
Roll call.
Wakefield?
Aye.
Brown?
Aye.
Britt?
Aye.
Lightcon?
Aye.
Olson?
Aye. Motion carried. Visitors and delegations, we got no way.
We have those two additional items on the
agenda. Yep.
Yep.
And we will start with Lucas on the ponds.
Okay, a couple of weeks ago, I asked Lisa to pull Ramsey County's bonded debt, just so that I could have an understanding of what we were looking at. Ramsey County's total bonded debt is $1,070,000. And it's term bonds, meaning that over the next several years, some of it has already come due, so it's a little bit less than $1 million, I suppose. But over the next several years, we have bonds coming due. However, in 2021, and so this isn't really pressing, but I just think it's important that we're aware of it. In 2021, we can actually call some of these bonds. And my understanding is that we could call the bonds coming due in 2025, 2027, and 2030. And in doing so, would save, if we called them and paid the principal up front, we would save on the interest payments for the years that we don't have them outstanding. And so there's not really a good reason not to do it, in my estimation, if we can find the funds to do it. And just to point out, if we called the last term bonds that come due, which is $210,000, we would be saving about $80,000 over 10 years in interest rates. So there's not really a good reason not to call them, because we can call them at their par value.
If at that point, just if we can fit it in the budget, it's a good idea. At least something to be on the radar, that's for sure.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. I suppose, Kevin, a lot of these bonds were when we were fixing roads in the FEMA.
Yep, they were
match
all
money.
Flood damage, yep. One year there was like six of them, so they all, our share of the six amounted to that.
Got rolled into one bond.
Yep, exactly.
So I just wanted to have it on everybody's radar that it's something to be thinking about, seeing as we have the luxury of thinking about it this many years out.
Like the first year I was on the commission, I started understanding all that, how we bonded to cover the match money for the FEMA projects.
Yeah.
And after that, we went after the state, because we thought, why put more burden on the taxpayers of Ramsey County by paying these bonds? And the state at that time giving $5 million to Ramsey County to match money for their FEMA project for the 10%.
Yeah, and annually on this last term, the ones coming due in 2030, we're paying a little bit over $8,000 per year on the interest. On the ones coming due in 2027, we're paying about $5,200. And on the ones coming due in 2025, we're paying $4,500. So it's not the hugest amount of money, but I mean, there's just not a good reason not to pay it off if we can.
Are you sure, Lucas, there's no penalties?
So, right here, the first...
Penalties for early pay?
So the first available call date, so in other words, we can exercise our right to call back the bonds any date after this until the date that they mature. And right here, the call price is 100%. So a lot of times, bonds that can be called early will be called early at a higher call price, but ours are not, so there's no penalty to call them back early.
We're gonna have some angry people holding our muni bonds that are gonna be making their interest money over those 9 years.
But some of them might want their money.
They might.
Through the stock market today, yeah. And another record, so.
Yeah, muni bonds are all pulled together in a big old portfolio.
The reason they get into these is they're
so stable, secure. Stable and secure.
So I just wanted to bring that up.
Okay, thank you.
Yeah, I appreciate it. Good idea. Thank you for bringing it up. Keep it on our radar and something.
Yeah. Yeah, like I said, we were very fortunate to help in the state at that time.
So how much would we have to pay back in 2021?
Well, that would depend on what bonds we wanted to call back. And I don't know for sure, so I don't want to quote, you know, but I mean, if we called back the full issuance of the 2025 bonds, we'd be spending $120,000. And we don't have to, like, just because the call date is 2021, we could call back bonds in 2021, 2022, 2023, and save, you know, 5 years, 6 years, and 8 years consecutively instead. And that would still be worth doing. You know, so it's not, I'm not saying that we have to find a way to set aside $500,000 to pay that bond debt. I'm just saying that it's something that we can be doing, and so there's not a good reason not to if we can. So that's all.
Okay. And the other was regarding the proposed amendment with the inmate population.
Yeah, this caught my eye. Sent it over 2015. This is the same thing they tried to do 2 years ago.
Yep.
So the cost of incarceration back in the county. Because there's some inmates that there's no way that we can handle them out here at this population site. And they need to be sent to Bismarck. And the district judges send them. So it's not law enforcement center's choice. They're going to put a cap on that. I believe it's either 5 or 6. That's what it was last time. It wasn't very many.
It wasn't a lot, you know.
Anything over that, we're going to probably have to pick up the bill down there. So I think we better definitely keep our eye on this. This could add up to be a substantial amount of money. Like I said, there's... You know, some inmates are just no way we can handle it out here.
Where's it at in process right now? It started on the Senate side as a delayed bill. Well, crossover is pretty quick, so it's got to hit the floor sometime this week on the Senate side then.
This week, yeah. Mm-hmm. I'm not sure where it's at.
I think Carrie is watching this.
She is watching that one? Yeah.
She's the one who sent the email to me and asked me to forward it to you guys.
Yeah, and we've talked about, we got inkling about it 2 weeks ago on our conference call for the legislative committee, and then obviously it got dumped in the hopper this last week when we talked about it last Friday. Mm-hmm. The state's attorneys have been down and talked about it pretty hard, saying we can't do this.
Yeah, the sheriff, I think the sheriff.
Yeah, the sheriff's too, the sheriff's as well. I believe the state's attorneys will hold me there. But, so, I mean, everyone's kind of on the same page that it would be just an absolute killer for some counties. Not all the county commissioners on the call were on the same page too, that this, it just, it's not feasible. But at the same time, you know, we understand the thought process on the call, because everyone understands that they gotta find a place to find some money in the budget, because they're looking at such big cuts and they just don't know where to find it. So the quickest place to find it is revenue.
But to
charge somebody.
But I thought, why did they go into prison? You know, and they want the counties to pay for it? And that's pretty much in essence what they're doing here.
Because it's full, I guess. I don't know. It's, you know, well, Judge Foddy was down before the meeting and visited with him a little bit about it. We couldn't remember the exact dollar figures, but a lot of it comes down to classifications of crimes, mandatory minimums, all those kind of things that are essentially completely out of our, you can't do anything about it.
Right.
You know, it's no different than social services financing or anything else. I mean, it, we're told this is what we have to do and then figure out a way to pay for it. Well, it's tough. Yeah, well, there's only one way to pay for it.
Property taxes.
Yeah. So, who knows?
But this was up 2 years ago, if you remember that, Adam.
Yeah, it was up and we fought it then. And it didn't get a whole lot of traction then, but...
No. Well, I got an idea. It might this time.
Yeah, I'm trying to remember which site killed it last time. I can't remember which site it started on.
I don't remember either.
Or if it got, even got through crossover or not, I can't recall. It's been a lot of numbers more in a couple of years.
Well, another question. Did any of you get to the farm at the high school?
I did, yes.
You did, Adam?
Yep.
Yeah, for you there?
I was there.
I was not.
What? Did you learn anything? I wasn't there.
You learned anything? I always learned stuff. I'm trying to think of anything that was directly... I mean, we talked a lot more about education stuff since it was before held at the school, but there were some things that we talked about that would affect counties. Obviously, the takeover of financing for social services was discussed. And, you know, like I stated, our legislators sounded like they were all in favor of it. It passed off the floor today off the Senate side, 43-2. I don't know who the two were, but...
be interesting to know.
Yeah, I would assume it's probably not a, I'm not sure if this, but there were two that voted against it in committee, so I almost wonder if they were the same ones on the floor or not, but I honestly have no idea. So there's going to be, you know, a lot of heavy lifting to do in the second half of the session, and I have a feeling that they'll probably, it's going to get turfed to finance and tax again, because it's got to go through the policy committee first before it goes to appropriates. So it'll be interesting. If it'll get out of finance and tax on that side and then go over to appropriations, then it'll probably just sit there until they get budget projections in March. Because it'll be one of the last things that's dealt with, I would guess, because they got to let the financial picture get in place. But, you know, keep calling our legislators and other legislators, and if you know anyone, talk to them.
Yeah.
If we want to get it passed, if it's something we want to do, I mean, it's just going to take a lot of heavy lifting and talking to people.
I think there's another forum this Saturday at the Pizza Ranch.
And there's another one like the March 11th or something like that as well. Or maybe it's the first weekend of March, I can't remember, but it's sometime in that time.
If you get Grand Forks Arrow, pick it up in a legislative forum in Grand Forks.
Yeah.
And quite a Twitter debate afterwards.
Yeah, the legislators
I read a little thing. I'm trying to think of anything else interesting. You know, it's not something that directly affects counties, but there was some discussion about Medicaid expansion. I say it doesn't directly affect us, but it indirectly affects us because the Human Services Center pulls so many dollars off of Medicaid expansion. And it's basically one of our only lines of defense when it comes to actual, you know, mental health care and addiction treatment services that we have in the community. You know, for people that can afford to, they can't afford to pay for it. And I can't remember when I went to this, to the advisory committee last year, I think they said it's something in the vicinity of $500,000 or $600,000 a year that Medicaid expansion provides to our Human Services Center.
Here?
Yes, just to our center. So they'd be looking at that budget deficit if they didn't do Medicaid expansion. It sounded as though our legislators were in favor of that. But that's one reason that they're going to hold back, attempt to hold back the 10 days. Because they're not sure what's going to happen with all of that, with, you know, national politics being what they are, if we're prepared to get scrapped, whatever, so they want to have some time just in case they've got to come back and deal with it. So, I don't think there's anything else.
No, you have any question that forecast in March is going to be a huge determining factor on how many these programs go forward.
Yeah, I mean, it's pretty obvious. I mean, you, every day you read the paper, the higher ed and everything, they're all, they're racing for it.
Yeah.
They know it's coming, it's just a matter of how bad it's going to be. So.
Well, and I was talking to Doug Darling at the last College Foundation Board meeting, and basically said that the first round of cuts that came through, they were able to budget for, but if the cuts that are being hinted at are going to come through, there's just nothing, there's no way without cutting programs and staff. So, it's going to be tough.
What did I read between the last cuts at UND and the next ones, just on the buyouts, you know, the early retirements, I think they're in the neighborhood of like 200 and some people, 210 people off of the campus, and then most of the colleges are looking at, like the College of Arts and Sciences just came up with their budget yesterday, and it's a 12% reduction is what they're shooting at, and that might even be low as of now. So there's, yeah, it's tough, more difficult then, and the thing that's going to be a kicker for us is we're not going to see that until we come back and start budgeting in August. We're going to have an idea, we're not going to have a total idea how much it's going to hit us if...
We're going to be pretty conservative.
You know, until county funds get, until we, you know, until we get out, then we'll have an idea of what we're looking at, but we won't have it in dollars and cents completely until we roll into that budgeting session in the late summer. So.
There's no way our property tax people can take a hit in our county. They can't.
Not nothing serious, no. We got at least try to hold it steady. Yeah, so it'll be interesting.
There's a congressional flood forum. The senators are having a flood meeting up in Drayton on Thursday at 2:00. Initially, they were having them, Senator Hogan scheduled one for Thursday morning in Grand Forks and Senator Heitkamp Friday in Grand Forks. And then they finally got together and decided, well, let's have one and we'll have it up in Drayton. That's Drayton and 2:00. And
2:00?
Yep.
Where at?
Not
hard to find Drayton.
I said, you're going around until you find where all the cars are.
You're there.
Yep, that's right.
I'll pull up the email.
Probably the Eagles or the VFW.
I don't know, they have
high school gym.
I don't think they have Eagles in Drayton.
It's been a long time. I don't even know if I've ever heard Drayton.
Are there any announcements?
The H.G. Johnson Memorial Hall, 115 Elmer Avenue.
That sounds like a VFW type, or maybe a American Legion or something like that.
Only one way to find out.
That's right. Yeah. I won't be here Thursday, unfortunately. I'd like to go.
I have a scheduling conflict as well, but I thought I'd pass that on if any of the commissioners can make it.
Yeah, the flood outlook we had in the,
on the 16th.
Greg Gust hasn't changed, but
hasn't really changed.
That's good information. Found out the meeting you had down there for the joint basis.
Yeah.
So.
Your next one comes out the 2nd of March.
Okay.
I don't think so.
Motion to adjourn.